So here we are now talking about the potential application cross-phase and cross-curricular of the use of Brian Clegg's newest product, Peel-Off Paint. Here we've got quite an interesting, sophisticated design, quite simply worked out as shapes that could be reminiscent of organic forms, flowers perhaps, and it has a Tiffany glass appearance to it. This, of course, could be used at everything from, again, key stage, end of key stage two, I suggest, certainly three, certainly four. This could appear in a GCSE exhibition, even through to undergraduate level. And can you imagine what a textile designer would be able to do with this medium as a sketching, ideas, planning process? Let me show you some simpler applications of the medium. This design is based quite simply on one shape, which is this consistent parallelogram here. These shapes are the exact same shape, but here I've mixed what we call a mid-tone, using the lightest tone and the darkest tone, and putting them together in an imaginative way that creates this box-type illusion, stepping sensation that one gets visually looking at it. And of course, this is fun. It's a great thing to do. Children of just about all ages could do this. Remember, it's easy to cut with a pair of scissors, and using alternative arrangements of these shapes, it's possible to make different patterns. It's also possible, of course, to turn this whilst you're working on it, to make completely brand new approaches and aspects of the pattern, and to create something of an optical illusion about where is the top, where is the side, where is the light coming from. Interesting exercise too in tessellation and matching of pattern. Let me show you another version of that. This time we're looking at almost identical shapes, but this time the shapes have been moved around to create brand new patterns. And this, with children of any age, could be an exercise to work out how many different patterns it is possible to make using the same number of identical triangular shapes. You could work on pieces of acetate, as we are doing here, photograph them digitally, load them to the hard drive, and make a whole collection of dozens of different sorts of patterns using a limited number of shapes and colours. Here's another one. This most simplest of designs, simply black and white, is based loosely on an Alhambra type of tile design. And here we could be talking to young people and designers, all ages, through from, again, key stage two, right the way to undergraduate level, about half-drop pattern. You can see how the black and white triangles are identical, but each time it reappears on the low level below, it's half-dropped, so the pattern appears halfway through. You can spot, too, that the pattern is turned by 90 degrees every time it reappears. So here, once again, ostensibly, creating images, making patterns, just having fun, cutting the material and moving it around. But here we're really talking about angles, drop pattern, and geometry. And finally, a possible application is to produce the product in 3D format. And here what we're looking at is possibly a three-dimensional interpretation of a Mondrian painting. It could, of course, used at key stage four, be a could be used at key stage four as a maquette or a small model for a stage set or an exhibition stand design.